Hello everyone, hello Nicolas,
Hello Hugo.
hope you are well. So
I'm
everything
well, thank you.
is good for you?
Perfect, I'm okay.
Okay, so welcome everyone. So we are very pleased to welcome you for this first webinar to discover SkyRail. So you can say hello to the chat so we can just wait for a few people that are here and just to Okay, tell us if you can hear well and see the pictures. Okay. So we will wait for just 1 or 2 minutes to get everybody connecting and getting the good support of the video and the sound. All right. Okay. So I hope that you are all in a good place and safe during this time and this period. And we thought it was a good time to get this moment together and to share with you some topics about SkyRail. Okay. So I think most of you are here. And then we can start. All right, so it's a real pleasure to start this webinar. And so what we would like is to show you very few stuff about SkyRail, how to start and what is SkyRail about, and to give you a live demo about SkyRail. So it will be some explanation, but a lot of demo. We will do that together with my colleagues. So today, the team for this webinar is, so myself is Hugo, so I'm the founder of SkyRail, and I will be the speaker for this session. And Nicolas, which is in charge of the quality and all the support for the users, will be doing the demo in VR. So you can see his screen for the moment in thumbnail. And Antoine, which is a business developer, which will do the moderator during this session. So together with Nicolas, we are connected inside SkyRail. So we will share the screen, and you will see at the same time the demo from the Nicolas computer and the screen from myself, which is let's say in connecting. Okay. So this screen that is here, this is the screen that it will be playing the VR, and this screen will be myself. Then you will see the collaboration mode, and of course on my side I don't have any VR it's a device, but it's also to show you that you can collaborate inside SkyRail with even on your standard laptop, and you can see what's happening and collaborate with people which are in immersive. Okay, so how does it so few stuff about this webinar. So to be clear, all your mics are muted and the session is recorded. So of course we will send you the link. So if you want to catch up, or let's say to show to some other colleagues, it's not a problem. On your right side, there is some tabs that you can use for chat or questions. So of course chat is for general chat, and but what we recommend is to use the question tab to raise any question during the session. And of course the idea of this webinar is to answer to your questions. And so what we will do is that we will make some breaks to answer to your questions. Okay, so there will be 3 demos of SkyRail, and each time we will follow the same sequence. First, it will be a slide of introduction, just to explain what it is all about, and then the demo, of course, which is the main part of it. And then we'll go to questions from your side to see if everything is clear or not, and if you have anything like this. Okay, so I think this is clear for you. So the agenda is to start with what we call the VR basics and the fundamentals, because one of our, let's say, our goal is really to make VR as simple as possible and to make this that everybody can use it in the engineering, let's say, departments and so on. So we are really focusing to make something which works with all the device and all let's say, any kind of immersive display. So that's why we're focusing this, and we want to first to show you the principles of that. The second point is a use case based on how to design in VR and to use a mannequin edition to create some posture of mannequin for operator position. The third one is about doing an assembly sequence and to simulate that with some kinematic arm, and you will see. Okay, so this will be the three demos. And at the end, of course, we will conclude with an overall question session and some additional information about scale. All right. So if everything is clear, I propose to start with the very first demo. So the very first one is about the basic. Okay, so as I said, so it's really to show you the very how we start this and what we could do. So the principle of our main control is to get something which is as easy as possible and is to use as less control button as we can, and to use only the trigger and the menu to do this. So it's, let's say, compatible with as much possible device as we can found. And it can be also for any kind of, let's say, sometimes you have controller with less button than other. So we try to make something which is, that can be adapted to any kind of device. So this is the Pi menu that you will see in action. And of course, in Skyreel, there is more than hundreds of features that you can put inside this menu. And of course, it's up to the user to configure his own Pi menu according to what he wants to do, according to the let's say the objective of the VR session that he wants to play with. And of course, the idea is not to put all the features in the same Pi, but just to adapt it to the session. And you will see a few examples during the demo. So here, what we are going to show you is very the basic how to navigate in VR and how to grab components. Okay. So let's see this in action. So here we are. So let's start. So just sorry for this. So you see, this is Nicolas. So you see as well his video. You see which is with using his VR display, and on the other side, you see myself here. Which is whoops, just a minute, like this. Okay, and you see that I'm here. Can see Nicolas, which is in character, and I can see live. So on my side, I don't have any VR, but I can see him and I can follow. Let's say what he's doing at the same time. Okay, so the let's put this one first. So let's focus on what's Nicolas doing. So Nicolas, so he can show you the file. So there is the two controllers. So you can use your left arm or your right controller. And you see, if you click, so there is two, you just need to know two buttons, one which is a trigger and one which is the action. So on your thumb, there is one thing which is highlighted. So here it's an Oculus Rift, but it could be any kind of other controller. And the trigger, which is on here, and this is the only thing you need to know. Okay, so with your the menu button, you can open the Pi menu. All right, and then you see there is here three submenus. So either you can manipulate here on the top, navigate here, and the selection. Okay, and you will see what we could do with that. So each time you need to just move your hand to see that, so you can see at the same time the video of Nicolas, which is doing it, and then you can open a submenu and there is other actions, okay, like this. Okay, so the very first time it's a little bit let's say new, but once you use that, most of our users are very familiar to it and it goes very fast. Okay, so here for the navigation there is three main modes. The first one is walk. Okay, so when you walk, you are ground, and of course you walk according to the surface of the ground. And you, so if there is an obstacle in front of you, like this wall, you cannot go through that. So it's very similar to, let's say, a video game and something like this. Okay, so there is some kind of, you cannot go through this. And a lot of, and if you want to, let's say the floor is like this, like a stair, you see it's getting up and down, of course, depending on the geometry. Right. So then the second one is the second navigation is teleport. So you can use as a lot of VR tools teleport, which is very like this one here, teleport. So you see from your controller, you can move, and of course, you can make a lot of jump And also you can go on, let's say, and change your altitude and so on. Okay, so you need to, the destination should be some kind on the surface, but it can be anywhere. And of course, it is very good for motion sickness. So for people which are sensitive to motion sickness, it is very positive. And the last one is the fly mode. So the fly mode is something which is also very, let's say, easy to use, so that you are not, you can go anywhere, and you can also go through any kind of parts, so you are not limited. And of course, it can be some kind, get some altitude and so on. So it's most dedicated for people which are, let's say, not afraid about getting altitude and motion sickness sometimes, because it can go some disturbance. And the last thing is that, of course, from all this navigation, you can play with the speed. So there is a speed trigger that you can show here. Okay, so then you do this. So you see it's a numerical value. So here, 4, it was the speed that you have before. And so you can either you get a little bit high or lower. Okay. So that's the navigation. The second point is about how to grab objects. Okay, so here, once again, there is many way to grab objects in Skyrail. And the very first one is to use what we call the laser. Okay, so manipulate with laser. You will see, so we are going to show you 4 of them. The first one is a laser, and so you see you have your two controllers, and each of them has a laser, which is green one, and you can grab it, and object in each hand, okay, and you can, let's say, drop them wherever you want. So it's quite easy to do, okay, and it can be, you can also be, let's say, in a certain distance of an object, you don't need to be in contact. So the second one is what we call the overlapping object, so it's the one which is here, manipulate overlapping object, which depends. So here now you have hands, okay, and it depends where your finger touch an object. Okay, so you pick up an object, and because your hands is in contact, then you can grab this one. Okay, and the one that we are, okay, it can be another one. All right. The third one is about the selection. So if you pick an object, like or several, okay, then you select first, and then you say manipulate the selection, and then you can grab these ones, okay. And this is very convenient to grab a group of an object, okay, because with your two first one you cannot do that, because you need to, if you want to, let's say, move these three objects at the same time, you need that, okay. And so it's quite convenient to do that. And then, of course, if you want to, let's say, use also the selection and to say, okay, this object I want to select it, but also with its parent, there is in selection a way to say, okay, I want to select all the parents in the product tree from this small object. And then if you say select an object, then you get more or less an assembly, the full assembly from the product tree point of view. Okay. And so you see that you can manipulate with the hand, so it's more or less in all the direction and translation, but you can do also the same with a compass. So if you select any kind of, so it can be the same as, yes, this one. There is also a compass, which is like in the CAD systems. And then you can, of course, apply let's say, you can see the value of translation, okay, or either in a plane or a rotation also. Okay, so very easy. All right, so this is the point, and I think we are done with this very first demo. And of course, so what I will do then, I will pop back. Okay, so do you have any question regarding this very first demo? I will see just a minute. Okay, so let me have a look. So yes, there is a question from Raphael about creating a tool of standard tools, wrench, racket, torque, and intent. So yes, it is something that exists. So it can be also from the CAD, from the CAD preparation. So inside your CAD systems, so you can from your CAD files, you can say this is a tool, and then it creates a library of torque, wrench, or whatever, and then you can access to it during the session. Yes, and then you can have your own library of all the tools and so on. Okay, so this is something we can show you definitely. And then the second point of your question, to snap the features. So this is the second point, is that of course all your tools will have connecting features. So of course you need to get some kind of this French as an extension and so on. So this is the second part of it, and we are working on this topic. So there is another question about grab points. So there is not yet, a way to grab an object. So as you see here, the drilling machine, like for instance, is not yet some kind of way to say how to grab a drilling machine, for instance. And right now, you can pick up, because for us it's just a mesh coming from the CAD, so there is no properties of how to grab a tool. But this is something we are definitely willing to do, to say, okay, each tools have its own way to be grabbed. And so a user, if he wants to grab a drilling machine, definitely it should be recommended to use it by the, let's say, where you're supposed to put your hand. All right. Okay. So what I propose is now is if you can answer. So on your polls tab, there is some questions. So we'd like to know if it's clear for you, so we can move to the next session. So if you can answer so the very first polls from your point of view, if it's clear or not, and if we can move to the next point. All right. Okay. I see there another question. So I saw that you have teleported navigation on the object. So it is navigation automatically built into an object that has been planned the navigation or something similar onto this object. Matt Butcher, I'm not sure to understand your question, but maybe I will answer it later on. Okay, and we will. So anyway, all the questions will be answered either during the session or after if it was not clear enough. So yes, there is also two people grabbing a tool at the same time. So no, it's not possible to have something like people that are, let's say, holding a huge things. So it's a matter of really physics and let's say who's controlling the things. But we could do something that is looking like this, but right now it's not possible. Okay, so I propose to move forward. So the next point is about, so we're getting more into details, use case, okay? And here, the first use case is about, let's say, how to design in VR and how to, let's say, do something about system design. And for instance, you have chematics of an hydraulics systems, and you want to be able to specify from an architect point of view where to put your systems and how to route the pipes and the system between the equipment. So this is the first part of the demo. And then once we have do this this system positioning and the pipes design, we will check that if from an operator point of view, it's possible to make this bracket fixing and all this that the operator will have access to this, okay? So let's move to Nicolas' view, and I will change mine at the same time. And we will see that. Okay. So, all right. So, you see, there is here we are, let's say, there is a system over there, and we want to, to create a route to another system. And the system, we would like to put it on below the window. So here we have a new submenu, and this one is to create a simple design shape. Okay, so we'll be able to create like a box, and this box will be space allocation for the system. Okay, so. And then once we have done this system, which is resize and reposition, we can do the routes of the pipe that will go from one to another that has to be connected. And you see that it is directly in 3D. And all this geometry, which is generated here, can be sent back to your CAD system, like CATIA, in native geometry. So it will create these pipes, for instance, and the volumes in Katia. Okay. So you see that it goes a very simple way. Oops. Let's see. I'm trying to follow him. Okay. And then it connects to the system. Okay. And in very few seconds, we have created a pipe and a system all together. Okay. And at any time, you can also re-edit the object and you can, let's say, readjust if there is, let's say, new rules, some design standard, and you want to check any kind of, that everything is correct and there is no collision and so on. Okay, so it does like this. And once you have done that, of course, the question is that, is it possible to get people getting this bracket fixed? So you need to see, is there enough space to do that, for instance. So there is another feature, which is about editing a mannequin. So here we have the capacity to drop and to spawn mannequin and to edit, let's say, very easily its position. Okay. So you see, it's a matter of enough space, so you see there is the capacity. So you see that Nicolas can incarnate for a few seconds the mannequin, so he can, let's say, get his arm on a good position, and at the end you can also add some manual constraint on different body parts. Okay, and you see that he has a possibility, and we can then as well do a second one. So let's imagine that it is a job that has to be in two people. One is about, let's say, holding the pipe, and the other it will be have to fix the brackets, and we can see how it goes and how to drop this mannequin. Okay, so once again, he can, let's say, incarnate the mannequin with his arm, and then he removes, and you see like in, and he can also add some tools that are here, and he can use it. And let's imagine that this mannequin has to hold a screwdriver. Okay, and so you see at the end, we can take a picture of that, so it can be for documentation or any kind of reports, and it is done. So you see, like in 5 minutes, we have designed, let's say, a system position, a routes, and we have also checked that. Let's say some operators will be able to access those different brackets. Of course, here it's just one point, but I guess you understand how it is working and how we can, let's say, do other points and very quickly do that. Okay, so then I propose to move, to move to your questions about this one. So let me just check what is your question here. So yes, the pipe routing is something which is the pipe routing is something that we have developed from scratch, and Skyrail is based on Unreal Engine, but this feature is not an Unreal Engine feature, and it's just something we built on our side. Okay. So a question from Johan, have you already implemented links between physical design and functional design for architecture study, for instance? So I guess you're talking about the chematics, the functional design, the links. So it's a very good question, and it's not yet done, but I'm sure you know that it's something we are very sensitive about, and we are this in our roadmaps to develop this point. And I would be love to do that. Can user play role of mannequin and other when observed? Yes, of course. So it's something we are always doing this, and I think maybe Nicolas can do it right now. If you stand up on your side, Nicolas, and go just outside the aircraft just to see this. So I will show you this in live. Let me show you just like this. Okay, so. Here you see on the left, you see my screen here, and then I will move back. Okay, So in fact, what I need to do is, it depends on each one of them. Oops, sorry. Okay, where are you? Yes. Okay. So can you, so the best way is to be on a walk mode. So you're like on the floor, you see, you can see him like this. You go on walk mode, Nicolas? Yes, here. And you see that I can, no, I cannot. So there is a way to see the mannequin. No, I will not do that. So there is a way, but it's not configured on my station. But, tracking product. Okay, it's not here. But I can do it. Definitely, I can do it. Let me just check in a minute. But so it's called See Other as Human. Oh, maybe. Let me check. Yes. Okay. So you see now I can see, so I will just move my screen in top. So you see on my screen, so oops, this one. So you see how I see Nicolas in the virtual world, and you see Nicolas, which is moving, which of course we are not in the same office, and you see how it's look like, okay? So you see it's, okay. So it's depend of each of us, decide how do you want to see others, let's say in mannequin or in a mode, okay. Which is different. All right. So this is okay. So it's something we can toggle on or toggle off. All right. So many questions. Let's. Okay, just a minute. I need to check that. Okay. Oops. Come on. Yes. So yes, we can. Can we incorporate any sensors to monitor Lex2? Yes, of course. So if you are using like Vive, for instance, you can use Vive tracker on your legs or on your to get some let's say more stable, or let's say if you are let's say in a different very specific position. Because right now, as you see, Nicolas has only his let's say his Oculus Rift, or it's only his head and his arm. But of course, if you add some additional sensors, it will be better. Can we import mannequin on Katia? So I guess it's importing the mannequin from Katia, the question. So the answer is no. And if the question is, can we import the mannequin from VR to Katia? Not yet, neither. Also, can we import custom human models and define them as a mannequin for the type of control you demonstrated? So mannequin can be animated. So you see that we can animate it, but the question is that can we create an animation? Yes, it's something we can do, and there is many ways to do that, and we can. Can user play role of mannequin and other one observed? Yes. Okay. Answer. Okay. So what I propose is to move to the next one. And at the end, we will go if there is additional question. So don't hesitate to vote for the right answers, so it would help us to answer to the most popular questions. So if you could also answer to the polls to see how did you appreciate this second demo, it would be good. So let's get some times to do that. Okay. All right. And then, so let's move to the next one. So the next one is about doing a full assembly sequence, and this assembly sequence is with, let's say, a robotic arm, which is it can be either an active or a passive, let's say, assembly assistance structure. Okay, and here there is a lot of kinematics, and we like to see how we're able to, let's say, to make this structure assembly, where there is this, you see this full structure, the blue part that is to be assembled inside the fuselage. Okay, so what we're going to show you is that how we can, let's say, use this kinematic and that has been, let's say, used before. First, it will be in an active mode. In active mode, that means that each part of the kinematic is considered as an engine, let's say, and we are able to pilot this. And then we can use it during the assembly sequence. And at the end, we can also have it in the, let's say, mode, which is a passive mode, where you just use, let's say, the end effector, and everything will be like a passive mode of that. Okay, so let's move to Nicolas' view, right? You got it? And so you see the structure, and on my side, I will move to this. Okay. So. All right. So you see that here, Nicolas can handle the structure, okay, and he can in fact control each element of the kinematic chain independently, and he can also. So the idea is to demonstrate: is it possible to get the structure inside the aircraft, okay, and to see that there is no, of course, a collision and no contact for this. And you see that it can also be used for any kind of training for the operators that will do that during the assembly station, because of course it's very it is a scale one okay prototype of this, so you can let's say see okay, do you have the good visibility to check the collision, or how do you can handle that? And then of course maybe sometimes the workplace is not so empty and you have to check everything okay, so it's also a matter of what is a good position to check everything and to be able to see that everything is safe and without any problem. Okay, so you see that you can control the system and make sure that everything is clear. Right, so we move inside, and there is a final. He has to connect these two elements. Okay, the green one, and then see that. Okay, and you see to do that each time this automated tool is like a solution, and you can drive it to the structure. Okay, and at the end it connects when it is done. Almost. Okay, and once it's done. He can also detach the structure, Nicolas, if you can, So then once you've done, you can remove the object, okay, from this. Oops. So you can remove everything, and everything is like the sequence is to, let's say, remove the structure here and leave the arm maybe to get another one. All right, like this. And then you can also, to get some kind of assembly of the system which are on the blue part. Okay. So then there is also the capacity to simulate the fact that you need to get this, mechanical part to secure everything. Okay. So you can grab it, put on the position, and you see it's thanks to what we called features, which is more or less some ghost position of the part, and you see which is the blinking, and you see where you have to put it, and you see that it's snapping on the good position. Like this. All right. So this is it, and then you can check everything if you can have access to with a tool. So if you need to add to grab a tool and to see if you have access to it, you can grab any kind of tool and see if it goes inside and if you have access to do that. Okay, like this one or any kind, and you see if it's possible to use this. So for instance, we can see that it's difficult, this kind of tool, which is of course not a good one, but this one will not fit for this kind of solution. Okay, and the idea is to turn around and see if you have the good path and if you have to change the tool. Once again, you could use a tool's situation. Okay, and let me then show you another demo about inverse kinematic. So this one is this thing that you see. So it's the same solution, but with now the passive mode. So the passive mode is really, so you grab the end effector, and then you see that you can move it, just the end of it, and you see that all the structure is moving. So you see the resolution is like, okay. So you just say where you want to be and to go, by manipulating the end of this solution, and you see that the joints are automatically calculated accordingly. Okay, so it's more easy. It depends really if the structure is passive or if it's active, like with engine. Okay. All right. So I propose to then see if you have questions for this one. So let's move to this one. All right. So let's go for questions, and I will do like this. Okay. So many of them. So yes. How about collisions? So here right now it's not we didn't activate the collision, but it's part of something we can do is to add the physics and the contact between the object. So we have two approach for that. The first one is either we leave the part, let's say, penetrating, and each time there is contact, there is a color rules that put the object in red or something like that. So the first one. Or the second one is to, let's say, create really a contact where you cannot make the object colliding together. Okay, so it's something we could also show you for our next demo. It will be something very interesting to share. How do you create kinematic constraints? So it's yes, it's something we have been creating. So from Johan, it's been creating in Unreal Engine. And of course, we are working to do that inside the Skyrail also at the same time. So can we use Haptic Glove? So the Haptic Glove is, of course, it's a good question. It's something we are working on also as well. And right now, it's not working, but it's something we are also part of the roadmap. Okay. All right. So I think it's correct, and if there is anything else, don't hesitate. So once again, there is a very short pause just to see how much clear was this demonstration for you. All right, let's see if you can check on the polls tabs. Okay. Okay, and then so you can continue to vote if you want. So is there any additional questions? So we have additional things to show you, but of course the first thing is to see if you have any questions. So one point we didn't talk about is how we create the scene. Okay, so right now here it's of course the main part of Skyrail is to use the CAD models to create your own world. Okay, so everything here is coming from CAD models, and okay, the idea is that if you can experiment, that if you have any CAD project, it's very easy to create your own experience from your CAD models, and it's something you can experiment by yourself very easily just by using Skyrail. Okay, so what I propose is to show you some, some site about what is coming from the next release, which is will be the 1.12 in less than a month, and we have a small video to show you about that. We'll be right back. So I don't know if you have any additional question. Let's say seeing these few things. So there's one question about from the point of view 3D scanning with drone. So it's really a matter of the quality of let's say your cloud of point. Okay, so of course there is it's a matter. I mean, more or less, everything can be imported, and really, it could be with a drone or any kind of tools. It will maybe have a matter of the result that you will have the quality. So there's a question about the recording of the webinar. Of course, we will send you the record of this webinar, and you will get access to this. It will be like a replay. I don't know if it's a YouTube link or something like this, but I'm pretty sure we will send you this, and it will be easy for you to replay as much as you want. Last but not least, One point about just to conclude about Skyreel. So what we have in mind, okay, is to continue to push about doing democratization of this VR solution for, let's say, a very general public and an audience in the industry world. And with really three keywords, okay. So the first one is to work on integration, okay. So one of our really focus is to see how much it can be easy to get this solution working inside an existing process, existing PLM solution, and all the data workflows that are necessary if you want to stream the files, if you want to, let's say, get this access to a lot of people. How do you manage that from the CAD systems to get everything ready? The second one is the simplicity. So once again, we try to make this the solution as simple as possible, but also at the same time to be able to customize it from your side, to add your own business features and so on. And the last point, of course, is the profitability. As we are in the industry world, everything is about business case and fast return of investment. Okay, so of course, we'll be very happy to discuss with you if you have additional question about Skyreel. And of course, we'll be happy to organize a second webinar. And of course, what we would like is to get your point, your discussion about what topic we'd like to see presented on the next webinar. So there is a poll on your right, and the topic are the proposition are the following. The first one is to focus on the data preparation from the CAD models. Okay, so how it works, what we can do, how we create the tool library, how we can create an environment, how we can merge, how we can create a lot of stuff. So this is the first topic. The second one is how to make the rework, the remote collaboration with or without VR device. And it could be very interesting during this kind of period where there is a lot of home office and like this. The third one is to go a little bit deeper inside this design in VR and how we can create this design in VR and send all this in back to CAD systems in the native format. This is the third one. The fourth is to see how we can use the power of Unreal Engine and to create an advanced customization of the experience with many, many additional stuff that are possible or during the control or to do some training support or anything like this. This one is about XR Center, which is our solution for data management and to get all the data that are, let's say, with a project mode and something which is, let's say, you get access right for each of your teams according to the project, and everything is well centralized. And the last one is about the cave and the power wall. Other displays than the head-mounted displays that can be supported, and also some kind of very interesting approach, and of course, which is part of things that we support. So could you please answer to this, so we will see if there is one topic that it is more interesting for you. And of course, we will go, let's say, we'll get you the webinar invitation so we can organize this in the next months, for instance, and so we can have this webinar up and running. Okay. I will just check if there is additional. So there's a question about, is it possible to create coursewares which check to validate if the people are following the procedure? So it's not something right now which is possible, but we are also working on the, let's say, training approach. And then you can create this, you can, okay, you will be able during the training module that we are working on to do that. Right now, if you want to do this following step-by-step the procedure, you need to use Unreal Engine and like doing this in blueprints so you can make this, okay? And we can, of course, show you how to do that because right now it's possible, but you need to use blueprints coding. Okay. So Antoine is offering you, like, okay, you see this pop-up to download the Scale demo if you're interested to try on your side. So it's a limited package of Scale. But it will, let's say, very first, let's say, contact with it. And of course, you can contact us if you want to try a full version and with your own CAD and so on. All right. Oops, I don't know how to do that. Yes, all right. Okay. There is another question that I didn't have time to see. Something is going on. I'm sorry. I have some latency on my side. All right. So that's is it legally possible to generate content of our client using your tool? Yes, of course. So the main point is to use Scale to generate, so you are completely autonomous to create your own content, so either for you or for your client. And so it's something you are fully autonomous, and it's not a matter of it's not a service approach. You use your own models and you import it on your system. And it's not something which is on let's say, on a server or whatever. You can do that on your side okay, without the full autonomy that you can do that. Okay. Then, okay, so if there is one or two questions in addition, I'm not so sure to be able that we have understood to all of them, but anyway, we will do that. We will answer to all of them if there is one that we didn't do time. Okay, so it was really a pleasure to, so I hope that you have learned some interesting points from your business and you can also consider, let's say, like Scale can be useful for you. So of course you can contact Antoine or myself if you have any additional question to on that. Of course you can go on the website or on the following links here and we will send it to you. So I really hope that you like it. So thank you so much Nicolas for the demo with the VR device and thank you Antoine for the moderating and of course we are here to let's say, for any question in private if you want. Okay. So thank you so much, and I hope you like this webinar. So thank you for all your message, a lot of thanks. And I hope we can get in contact very soon.